Hello again. It is 8:55 on your Tuesday. 70 degrees outside and getting way hotter, Tim.
Yeah, it's going to get way hotter way faster than any day we've seen so far this year. These will certainly be the hottest temperatures we've had so far in 2020. Today, we are going to be about 20 degrees, 15 to 20 degrees warmer than some spots yesterday. Yesterday, we got to about, you know, the upper 70s to about 90 degrees. Well, today we'll be in the mid 90s. So 94 and 95 for today and tomorrow. Tomorrow, much warmer with near record temperatures. We'll be in the 80s from Thursday through Monday with a chance of an afternoon thunderstorm every day from Thursday right on through Monday. Overnight lows down near 70 and in the mid 60s. Now, checking roads with Christy Breslin with WJZ Traffic Control. Hey, Christy.
Good morning, Tim. Good morning, everyone. Well, the main roadway is still in pretty good shape. Behind me, you'll see the 95-8-95 split. Smooth sailing. We love that. As far as accidents go, they are everywhere. Southbound 95, watch for an accident there at White Marsh Boulevard. Then that's going to take us over to the crash that we've been watching so far this morning on the inner loop of the Beltway. That accident is at Wilkins Avenue. Also, watch for another one northbound on the Harrisburg Expressway at Belfast Road. And we also have a new one coming in northbound 97. That one is at 648. That is the second one in this location this morning. Back over to you.
Christy, thank you. There's a public outcry to defund police departments in the wake of George Floyd's death. Amy Kawada has the response from the city.
This week, city council members will be discussing and eventually voting on the budget for this upcoming fiscal year. And many people are now asking to reallocate funding that would otherwise go to the police department. This comes as city council members begin to decide how to balance a $3.9 billion budget. The chair of the city budget and appropriations committee, Eric Costello, tells WJZ the committee is divided on whether or not to make cuts to the police department, which is slated to receive a proposed $545 million. The committee will hear from Police Commissioner Michael Harrison about the department's funding this Friday. The city charter requires the budget to be signed by no later than June 26. For WJZ, I'm Amy Kawada.
And join us again for more news and weather today on the News at Noon. Your time is 8:57.